Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. This is your host, Elder Gregory Newsom with the Faith in God Internet TV. We're here in the name of the Lord. As we start our broadcast today, we're going to go before the Lord in a word of prayer. Let us pray at this time. Eternal God, our Savior, in the precious name of Jesus, Lord, as we come before thee and before thy throne, we want to tell you thank you. We want to tell you we love you. Want to tell you, Lord, how worthy you are of the praise, all the honor and the glory that we have to offer you. And Lord, we give you true worship. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we lift your name. Bless your people, God. Lord, as we petition you right now, God alone, you're worthy of all honor and glory and praise. Lord, we thank you. And Lord, with you, we can overcome anything that come in our path. Lord, including, oh God, this virus that have attacked our world. We pray, God, in the name of Jesus. Right now, Lord, we're asking you to heal those that are sick among us. Look on our bishop, look on our evangelist Lee. Look on the many that are sick. Look on the Pentecostal Power Church family. We pray, God, you will protect those that are not sick and those that are sick. We pray, God, for your divine healing and deliverance in the name of Jesus. Lord, bless. Bless your people, God. Bless in this circumstance. Strengthen the church, Lord. Continue to open up our understanding. Continue to bring us together, God, that we will reach out and meet the needs of others and those that are around us. Oh, Lord, we need you to calm fear, move doubt, increase faith, fill us with hope, joy, and your peace, Lord, as we continue to trust in the living God. Oh God, we thank you. We give you glory and praise. And Lord, renew us, revive us, and let your anointing be revealed. Manifest your presence, Lord, in the lives of those that need you most. And Father, we thank you. We forever give you praise. We pray for every nurse, every medical professional. We pray, God, you will continue to embolden them with faith in you, God, in the name of Jesus, that your blood will cover them and you will keep them, Lord, as they minister to the health of others. And Father, we thank you. We forever give you praise and we declare victory in Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. We give God glory. Yes, yes. We're here in the name of the Lord. So we're here. Let us get started today. As we get ready to get into the word of the Lord, let us go to our scripture passage. And we want to talk, amen, from the subject, amen, of the faithful and the faithless. And our subject today is that it is time to increase our faith. Praise the Lord. It is time to increase our faith. Praise the Lord. And so we were talking on yesterday from a very familiar passage of scripture, which is found in St. Luke 8:25, also St. John 17:1-6. I'm sorry. St. Luke 8:25 and also St. Luke 17:1-6. I'm sorry. And so now we did review yesterday for your hearing Luke 9:41. Praise the Lord. And so we're going to start off, amen, also at St. John 20:24-27. That was another scripture that we read on yesterday. Okay. And so that's where we were on yesterday. And as we pick it up, we're going to also go to Hebrews chapter 10, verse number 23, and also Hebrews chapter 4, verse number 2. And we also going to get 1 John 5 and verse number 4. 1 John chapter 5, verse number 4. Okay, so we'll repeat that for your hearing again. We're going to be going to a familiar passage of scripture, which is found in Hebrews chapter 10, verse number 23, Hebrews chapter number 4, verse number 2, and also 1 John chapter number 5, verse number 4. Praise the Lord. And so we're going to encourage you from those passages of scripture today. We're going to try to be brief in the broadcast today, because we want to definitely open it up for those of you that may want to join us or may want to share what God has placed in your spirit as well. And so we're here today. We're going to go straight to a very familiar passage of scripture. And so we ask that you would take your time and go to it with us. And we're going to go to Hebrews chapter 10. And we're going to go to verse number 23. Okay. And in Hebrews 10 and 23, it reads for your hearing. Let us hold fast the profession of our faith without wavering, for he is faithful that promised. Praise the Lord. And, you know, I'd like to go a little bit farther than that, but read it in your study time. He said, let us hold fast the profession of our faith without wavering, for he is faithful that had promised. And we want to let you know it's time to increase our faith, because God is not a man that he should lie. God is faithful. We can depend on God. One of our saints that used to be with us, now she's pastoring, and she sang a song, "You Can Depend on God." And I truly know that to be true. Pastor LaJoyce Dotson, she sings that song, and she sings it very anointed when she do sing it, because she has the experience through the trials and tests that she's been through, that you can depend on God through the storm. And she said through the rain and through sickness and in pain. And so I want to encourage the people of God today. And as we get started in this subject matter today, we definitely honor our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to the utmost. We do honor, amen, our pastor, where we're under the leadership of our Pastor Bishop Ellis E. Murchison of the Pentecostal Power Church at 2331 West Center. We definitely thank God for him and give a shout out to our bishop. Praise the Lord, Pastor, and to Lady Murchison, to my own wife, Missionary Newson, to Elder Thompson, and to the entire Pentecostal Power Church family. We give a shout out to you all, and definitely to all of our current listeners and subscribers. We thank God for you. And as we talk about it's time to increase our faith, here in the 10th chapter of Hebrews, Apostle Paul, if you study the 10th chapter, or you study the book of Hebrews, period, it has been cited that Apostle Paul had written this particular book as well. And so just give you a little preface here. And so he is encouraging, or he's emphasizing to the people of God, the believer, to hold fast to the profession of our faith without wavering. And so it's very, very important for us not to waver in our faith. And it doesn't matter if there happen to be trials or tests, or even persecution or stress or problems, we still have to hold fast, you know, because we have a great privilege with this new life in Christ. We have, you know, access to God through Christ, because he's the mediator, praise the Lord. And so we can grow in our faith, overcome our doubts and our questions. And definitely, amen, we can deepen our relationship with the Lord. Praise the Lord. And so when we don't waver, there's an opportunity for us to grow in our relationship with the Lord without wavering. And so Paul is, you know, he's encouraging, you know, each one of the believers to enjoy the encouragement that one another brings in this faith, that we may worship the Lord together. As you look at Hebrews 10 and 25, you know, about, you know, not forsaken to assemble ourselves. So when we come together, we can enjoy, you know, worshiping the Lord together. And that's a beautiful thing when we can worship the Lord together. Praise the Lord. And so I know during this pandemic, churches have the social distancing protocol, you know, that has been mandated, you know, by our, you know, governor and our president. But it's very important for us to not neglect meeting together. And even though we can't physically meet, we can meet through social media platforms. We still can meet, you know, through the podcast and encourage one another and keep that fellowship. And that's what this whole thing is about. It's about staying connected to the body of Christ, staying connected to the Lord. Praise the Lord. And so that's what faithfulness is being all about. Faithfulness is about carrying out God's divine order. Praise the Lord. Amen. You know, we can have our own agenda, but it's a more blessed thing when we can carry out God's divine order and encourage others to latch hold and get saved and repent of their sins and get baptized and, you know, want to, you know, live, amen, this life toward God. Praise the Lord. And we cannot do it, amen, amen, without the Lord's help. Praise the Lord. We need the Lord, even in a time like this. We need to exhort one another, the book says. You know, it says, you know, that we should not forsake the assembly, you know, ourselves together as a manner of some, but exhorting one another. And so much more as we see the day approaching. Praise the Lord. Can't you see what's happening in our world today? It is fastly approaching the end time. And so I'm here to encourage you. Let's, you know, let's bind together our forces. Let's support one another through the social media platform. And our bishop is going to be coming on. And I'm very, very excited because our bishop is going to be coming on the podcast. We're going to make sure that we try to get him on. If we can't get him on tomorrow at 12 noon, we're definitely going to shoot for Thursday, if the Lord's will, to get our pastor of the Pentecostal Power Church, Bishop Murchison, on the line so he can share also some brief words of encouragement or however the Lord may lead him. It may be brief, it may not, but however the Lord direct him, we want to hear from our bishop. Praise the Lord. And I thank and praise God all is well with our bishop. So just want the saints to keep praying for our pastor. He's doing fine because Jesus is alive and well. And so is our bishop. He's alive and he's well, praise the Lord. And so we thank God for his divine healing upon our leaders, even our presiding and assisting presiding bishop of the Pentecostal Power Churches and the Executive Council Board of Bishops. We give a shout out to them. We thank God for what God is doing for our leadership. And let's pray for our leadership that in times like these, that God's blood will continue to cover them, that they can, amen, carry on and carry out God's mandate. Praise the Lord. Amen. So we thank God for that. I hope I said something to encourage you, but we want to grab these other two scriptures. I took a sidebar there, but want to grab these other two scriptures that I called, and we want to go ahead and get into Hebrews chapter 4. We're going to go ahead and get that. And so we're going to take a look at Hebrews chapter 4 and verse number 2. And so bear with us just a second here. All right. And so we had Hebrews chapter 4, verse number 2. It says, "For unto us was the gospel preached, as well unto them, but the word did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that heard it. Lord, have mercy. I'm going to need more time to deal with this. It's important that we don't waver. It's important that we have faith applied in this particular time that we're in today. If the word is to profit us, we must take the word at face value. We must believe what is written. You know, one of our late Bishop Lavelle Tyler, he used to always say this, you know, Jesus said it. The apostles wrote it. And then he said he quoted. And so that means we have to have faith and confidence in the word of God. We have to believe what's been written for us. And as we know, there was an example here that was given here in Hebrews chapter 4. He says in verse number 1, he says, let's go up to top to verse number 1 so we can get the gist of this. He says, let us therefore fear lest a promise being left us of entering into his rest, any of you should seem to come short of it. Praise the Lord. You're going to come short if your faith is not up to par. We're not in that position to be coming short in the time, in the days that we're in now. As time gets closer to the end time, we should be looking up, knowing that our redemption draweth nigh. And so there's no time to waver in your faith. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We need to latch hold and get a tighter grip, my friend. Praise the Lord. We need to get a tighter grip on Jesus. Praise the Lord. And so I'm here to encourage you today. Don't come short in the things of God. Step up your game. You know, step up your momentum. You know, step up your praise, worship, adoration with a heart of thanksgiving. Give God praise in times like these. We're not only the, you know, because we're faithful, we praise the Lord regardless of the circumstance, in regardless to the circumstance, because our God is worthy of all praise, glory, and honor. Praise the Lord. And we thank God for him being by our side. God will not fail us. He definitely will not come short of what he has said. And as I said in Numbers 23 and 19, we can see from the Old Testament to the New Testament, God is not a man that he should lie. If he said it, he's going to make it good. If he's spoken it, he's going to bring it to pass. Praise the Lord. You can depend on God. And so it's time for us to increase our faith, amen, and not waver. Hold fast to your profession. I think Apostle Paul said, for thou hast professed a good profession before many witnesses. He said that in Timothy there. You know, we should definitely hold fast to this thing. As I get ready to close out today, we're going to get our final scripture, which is found in 1 John. I want to go ahead and get that one because we didn't want to be really long today. But we wanted to encourage you today, and we hope that we said something that may encourage you. We're going to continue on with this topic. We're just going to go a few at a time each day because we got quite a bit of ground to cover. We're going to go to 1 John. Chapter 5 and verse number 4. Okay. He says, for whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. It's essential. If we're going to get through this thing, which I know we are, the saints of God, the people of God, we as a nation, I believe the Lord that he will get us through these difficult times. But we can't waver. We can't depend on the government. We can't depend on the president. We can't depend on the governors. And we definitely can't depend on a stimulus check. Our faith has to be in God. Our hope has to be in nothing less than Jesus Christ and his righteousness. There it is, my friend. Put your hope and your trust in God. Praise the Lord. Because we can depend on God. Praise the Lord. He's the one that overcometh the world. And therefore, if we have the overcomer on the inside of us, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. So you are an overcomer, my friend. Be encouraged and forever be lifted up in the God of your salvation. And I hope I said something to encourage you today as we get ready to go into our call line. We're going to open up the line for about 10, 15 minutes for those of you that want to call in. We thank God for those that have chimed in through the Podbean app. And so you can always get us on podbean.com, and you can search for the particular broadcast, Fidget TV, F-I-G-I-T-V. We're also on iTunes. You can also search for Fidget TV. We're on Spotify. You also can search for Fidget TV. We're on YouTube. You also can search for Fidget TV. And we're also on LinkedIn, Facebook, and most of the other media platforms that's commonly used. And so you can always search for it. We also post a link on Facebook Live. If you want to be able to download the app or the link, just please click on the Fidget TV particular splash screen, and it will take you right into our podcast. And so we do thank God for you. We definitely give our prayers and support to all the saints. We say a special prayer for our evangelist, Joyce Lee, and Deacon Tony Lee, our head deacon, Deacon Tony, and to all of our deacon brethren. We're praying for all of our mothers and all the saints. And so we want you to be encouraged and know that it's time to increase your faith. Don't waver. Hold fast. Praise the Lord. Hold fast and don't let no man, you know, take your crown. Don't let no man steal your joy. And definitely don't let the enemy discourage you in times like these. Amen. Believe, amen, in God. He said, you know, believe in God. Believe also in me. And he says, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. And so if God lay out a promise over the people of God, we can cash in on it. Praise the Lord. And so we thank God for you. We pray that we have said something that would encourage you. And we're hoping that you would call in. And our call in number is 414-628-0568. We're getting our second line repaired, but you can definitely call us on our main line, which is 414-628-0568. If you want to give a shout out, if you want to come in live on the broadcast and share, you're welcome to do so. Our number is 414-628-0568, 414-628-0568. Please call us. We'd like to hear from you. We'd like to have you on the line with us. Praise the Lord. And so it's time to increase our faith. It's time to hold on to God. It's time to get a tighter grip on your faith. There's no time to, amen, waver. Amen. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. Praise the Lord. And so we need to make sure, amen, that our anchor holds and grips a solid rock. Praise the Lord. And so we're going to play a little gospel music while we're waiting on the line. Again, our call-in number is going to be 414-628-0568. We're here. This is your host, Elder Gregory Newsom, with the Faith in God Internet TV. We're here. Call us. 414-628-0568. We're here. Increase your faith. Faith come by hearing, hearing by the word of God. You need an increase? The Lord is able. Yes, yes. It's time to increase your faith. Please call us. Our call line, telephone number 414-628-0568. Please call us. 414-628-0568. Please call us. We're here. You got 5 minutes to call us. 414-628-0568. Please call us. Please call us. 414-628-0568. Fidget TV. We're here. Please call us. That we would touch and agree with you. That God would send an increase of faith. Please call us. 414-628-0568. We're here standing by. The lines are open. Please call us. Please call us. 414-628-0568. We're here. We're praying for you. We're praying for your increase. Well, bless the name of God. All right, we must sign off, but we thank God for you listening to us one more time. This is your host, Elder Gregory Newsom, with the Faith in God Internet TV. God bless.